And back over here. Greetings and salutations. This is Shadows Behind the Throne 2. Enhanced edition. Fancy. It's pretty much the forefront in simulations of being evil. Let's start. Got various names. Give you powers and stuff. Got the promise of teeth. Every prey creature knows its fate from the moment it is born. Its life exists as food for another. And 10,000 eyes watch its every movement, 1,000 jaws salivating expectantly. Its life will be a constant battle to postpone what it knows will eventually come. One day it will be too tired, too slow, or too weak. That day may come at any moment, even in its prime. Regardless of the prey's actions, there is the inevitable fate, the guarantee, the promise of teeth. Against a dark power such as yourself, the race of humans know themselves as prey. Powers granted: Beguile, reduce evidence, reduce suspicion. This dark name is designed to provide a more straightforward gameplay within the political sphere. The powers are focused on direct manipulation of social interactions, allowing you to spend power to ascend in society and bend it to your will. Then we got the drowning of the sun. The spark spills out across the nations, flowing from the cities somewhere. Somehow our sins made manifest. It blots out the sun. The light which remains is pale and sickly. Whatever warmth sunlight once had, it no longer holds now. Worse, shape. I think that should be shapes. Shapes move. Moves. Words. Words, motherfucker. Can you speak them? Worse, shape moves in the fog. They hide in it whilst its white cloak and act with coordination and purpose. The fog makes it nearly impossible to find them and prevents whatever vile conspiracy they are engaged in. Powers granted? Well, a fog. Draw fog. Convocation. The name allows you to generate a sea of fog emerging from the nobles under your shadow. Any enthralled, broken, or enshadowed nobles can be used to add to the sea. Within the fog, your agents and nobles operate better. Specifically, security is reduced. Your agents do not take damage from being exiled in locations inside the fog. Nobles will take longer to become suspicious of other nobles with evidence if these are inside the fog. Then we got Merchant of Nightmares. Fear is a disease. Ooh, is it ever? Spreading from mind to mind by word of mouth, by printed propaganda, and by whispered rumor. It saps at reason, undermines logic and caution, drives the afflicted to seek any refuge, any escape, any safety, regardless of the consequences. Those stricken by terror will fall into whatever traps are laid before them, too concerned with the foes, real or imagined, they flee from. Powers granted, denounce leader, instill dread, spread fear, break mind, polarize by fear, call to violence. This name revolves around creating, then spreading fear as seen by nobles' threat items across the population. The fear can be used to divide the population and topple established power structures, leaving a vacuum for you to rise to the top of. Once there, you can begin a campaign of military conquest, constantly expelling any who oppose your rampant militarism. Note that this name's power are better suited for spreading existing fear than creating it from nothing. Other names. Finding prime targets or creating suspicion of your true nature may be useful in starting the process. The Wretched Birth. The darkness does not come to end all life, but merely to grow a new way to live. Life springs up in great masses, emerging from the ground and reaching into the world to take its first breaths. This new life is terrible, blasphemous, and utterly hostile to all human life. The world of men will be replaced by an abomination of flesh and tooth, serrated claw, and twitching eyes. Powers granted. Expand the flesh. Seed the flesh. Screaming flesh. Rally the flesh. Protect the flesh. And withdraw the flesh. That's a lot of flesh. The stem works by creating a hostile mass of flesh stretching across continents. While the grass creature cannot prevail against strong foes, it can chip away at weakened empires. If you can provoke civil wars and international conflicts. Next power. Winter Scythe. It was always humanity's violence which would doom it. Human history is the history of warfare, waged pointlessly between leaders who sent tens of thousands to die for a cause they would never profit from and had no connections to. The peasants die for the games of the nobles. Each senseless death kills not just the soldiers, but the world itself, slowly sapping the life out of the world as the battle rages. The world grows colder with every sword blow struck as Winter's Scythe reaps the misery sow in fear. Powers granted, death is the sun, cold as death, ice in the blood. This stock name revolves around the provocation of constant war to destroy the world's climate. Each battle between human forces can be exploited to slightly reduce the world's temperature, either in a region or worldwide. Slowly, the farmlands in the north become uninhabitable, and the people force south into ever-dwindling habitable regions until those too are overrun with the snows. Your strategy should be to cause wars regardless of purpose. Inducing civil wars and kingdoms across the map gives death to use. Declaring war of conquest on your neighbors can lead to the entire world suffering. Even uprisings against you will fuel your victory. The priests in the deep. Cthulhu bullshit shenanigans, essentially. Beneath the waves, the light of the sun never shines. Faint shimmers make it down a few fathoms, but no further. Far, far further down, unnatural creatures make their own lights, flickering and blinking like drowned stars. Among these creatures raise up giants. Amongst these creatures raise up giant cities of granite and obsidian, and temples to beings far beyond the reckoning of man. On the surface, these prayers are felt as unearthly calls to join those who dwell beneath the waves. The deep ones, worshipping their blasphemous gods. Powers granted, establish deep one lair. Cult of the deep, war on the surface, haunting song, abyssal sirens, withdrawal to the sea. This name revolves around the deep ones, a race of beings made by corrupting humans and drawing them beneath the waves. They build up colonies near human settlements, use their siren songs to confuse humans to their cult, then assault the land when the surface dwellers are weakened by internal conflict. They are powerful against coastal nations by starting cults, which can infiltrate their settlements, driving coastal nobles insane or launching full military attacks on their land. Deep One colonies start hidden, reducing the threat perceived by nobles, but you must still keep an eye on the dread you accumulate and temporary threat, lest you be attacked before you are ready. And then you got the cheat name. Omnipresent Darkness. The darkness! It's everywhere! And in everything. All that I see. Absolute horror. The light is just temporary bout of fevered hope. To be rapidly extinguished like a candle in a storm. The darkness has all names and all faces. Everything which was feared is true. Powers granted, this dark god has access to all abilities. Not necessarily recommended for normal gameplay. This dark name allows for all powers for all other names. We're gonna be going with the new one that was added recently. The Drowning of the Sun. And I think we'll go with Wretched Birth. Yeah. So you got seeds. This over here is new. Beforehand, it was just like a matter of time before victory was achieved. You just keep on doing your evil thing, spreading terror, despair, and dismay across the land. Now, the humans actually have a way to bite back. Neat. Challenge. Game is slightly less chillaxing now. But, don't worry. We are the villainest of villains. So, we should do alright. We're just going to normal start here. Click the buttons. Everything good? Yes. All right. Let's start the game. So, yeah, if you're not someone who doesn't who wants some fancy graphics, this is not the game for you. This is a map game. You look at the map. And your objective? Either murder absolutely everyone, or have them, join your culty shenanigan bullshit in Shadowman. Get enough people in Shadow, the world's just, kind of under your control. No bloodshed needed. But we're not that kind of, we are not that kind of evil. So we're gonna seed some flesh. A seed of the unholy flesh, a large bulb the size of a man. It is feared that this is not coincidental. Dark brown in color, encoded in pulsating veins and arteries. From it, if it is not immediately destroyed, entire fields of writhing flesh will be spawned. You begin to grow a growth of unholy flesh. The swarm of fleshy protrusions is a reasonable combatant, but excels in instilling fear in nobles, aiding political goals. You may continue to grow and control this social group with further interactions. Gonna use our ability again. And we're gonna create an agent. Agents are essentially your way of interacting with the humans. They all have different skills. Got your vampire, stealthy infiltrator, and corrupter of their aristocracy. The vampire is an agent able to particularly conceal their actions. They must drink blood to survive and to power their magics, but can travel great distances between their places of feeding and the places where they act. This makes them good infiltrators and political agents, as they can escape the consequences of the crimes for a great deal of time. You got necromancers! Yeah! My favorite. Necromantic doctors pose as plague doctors to gain access to corpses, which they load onto the wagons for disposal. Once sufficient are gathered, they can raise armies of the undead. They gather corpses from graveyards and need to travel far to collect sufficient for large armies. This nomadic life may well leave evidence behind if they are unable to infiltrate or find recent battlefields. Got the Seeker. The Seeker is compelled to search the world for forgotten secrets about a race of creatures which ruled the world before humanity to gain dark power. They are weak for most of the game and may need other agents' help to avoid getting exiled, but after gathering their fragments, they can unshadow or destroy entire empires. The Dark Hierophant. The Dark Hierophant is the preacher of your blasphemous faith. They convert nobles to your cult once you have infiltrated their locations. They allowed you to enthrall the single noble to act as your political instrument and can break the souls of other nobles, preventing them from seeing evidence of the darkness and making them your accomplices in your rise to power. And then lastly, the Mask of the Red Death. The Mask of the Red Death is a spirit of the dread disease. The disease will slowly eradicate human settlements by decreasing their population and cripples any army which relied on the infected settlement for support, leaving the nations weakened in the face of outside threats. If played as a political tool, however, it is possible that the nobles' panic and selfishness will harm them more than the disease ever could as they squabble over who and where to protect over limited cures. We are gonna go with a vampire. The world has many servants of the darkness. All manner of wretches and abnormalities stalk the night and in the darker places of the world, waiting to be called into service once more to play their part in a greater plan. One of these is now under your control. You draw upon the creatures of darkness. Choose one to serve you as your instrument. Right, so we got a vampire. Let's send him off to a nearby town to go get into some shenanigans. Some power. Expand flesh. Unholy flesh grows in the fields, expanding its reach. Nightmarish, tangled masses of twisted limbs, arms, legs, and jaws, and prehensile tongues, tipped with claw, fang, and serrated tooth. Ooh, sounds fun. And move you over there. Use your ability. How are you doing on drinkage? And have a little sip. And use a power again to expand the flesh. And try and expand my way from here all the way over to here in hopes of having another seed somewhere. You wanna try and have at least two seeds, cause when humanity decides to come screw your shit, cause they're terrified of you, they're gonna just barrel straight for the seed. And then everything else can't grow anymore, cause there's no seed. So multiple seeds dotted around can sort of help keep your unholy abomination of flesh, teeth, and bone alive for that little bit longer. As you save up your points to keep expanding the flesh, never letting up on the assault. So, and then, it's do a little bit of infiltrating, yeah? And expand the flesh. In turn. And we are out of power. So, no. Create. No. Create agent. We're gonna get a seeker this time. They're fairly powerful. Late game. Once you got all the secrets. But getting the secrets in the first place without being banished is another story. Vampires regarding Charlie, they're not a natural presence, a perfect predator. Able to deceive their prey with ease, gaining access is easy when you can win the trust of the gods with a simple smile, and easier still when you can climb a vertical stone tower as easily as a man can walk a street. Oh, damn. That's a lot of infiltration. Nice! How about, we infiltrate again? Guard patterns can be learned, copies can be made of keys, a trusting noble can be exploited, knowledge gleaned, an agent can gain a lot from a tour of the defenses by a proud countess. Ability to gain access in this place increase. Yeah, blah 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 blah. How are you doing? Three more turns on you. Yeah, hello. This is Shadow behind the throne too. This is just chill little game where you destroy the world. Nice, relaxing villainy. What's not to love, right? Just sit back, relax, and watch the world burn. Uh-oh. Somebody's raising province security levels. Oh, yeah. Ah, in times before, the gods were more present, it seems. Not the gods worshipped by the race of humans, but the great beings of unknowable power and intention, with desires which a human could never understand. The civilization before humanity spoke with them, or perhaps just listened. All records speak of some singular great truth they learnt from one, a key secret revealed to them at their end. Off we go to get our next secret. As we continue to infiltrate. This place has a piece of knowledge. We seek. We must know.
We are at
in 64. So how about we are, how am I doing on drank? I'll be fine. I'll be fine. Just gotta. Another secret. Nothing attacked those who came before. No external threat. No disease. No disaster of the weather. They killed one another, then themselves, every single last one in a matter of weeks. Cities would certainly turn to self-destruction and produce no further records. The last writings of their neighbors would simply be, "We are next." On to the next secret. And shadowing people. Moving, learning the secrets of the past. Not so some other evil, villainous things can be had if you too buy behind the throne. Shadow behind the throne too. And like a whisper, the shadow enters subtly, so slowly you wouldn't notice if you weren't looking for it. Over the course of weeks, the days get slightly shorter and the candles burn slightly dimmer. The air grows still and tense. The inhabitants, reassured by friendly faces, remain unaware for now. And then we're just gonna use the. No. Use power. Full of fog. The mist descends, drowning out the sun and leaving the world suffocated under white miasma. The light which shines through no longer brings any of the warmth and goodness which the light of the sun does, and the shadows lengthen. With every day, a town remains lost in the fog. Neat. Where did I leave? Cover another secret, shall we? Let's have a wee bit of a drink, yes? Then, we'll do some more infiltrating. Oh, yeah. Like I was saying before, this is a map game. Turn-based strategy. Not your cup of tea? No problem. Don't buy it. Don't spend your money. Don't play it. If you are, however, quite fond of turn-based games, map games, and things like that, where you get to be a big old evil mastermind motherfucker, just get all Siege-ian on Machiavellian shenanigans. You know, sit back, relax. And be evil. Yeah, pick it up on Steam. Give them your dollary dues. So maybe we can get more bells and whistles on this motherfucker, yeah? Yeah, how long have I been? Yeah, 20 minutes. Yeah, you pretty much get the gist of the game. You click the buttons, you do the evil, you watch the downfall of society. Maybe you win, maybe you don't. That's all she wrote. Time to.